logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Annie Sheikh and today's headlines are... In India, PM Narendra Modi will meet Chinese President Xi Jinping, and Centre has set up a panel to probe racial discrimination faced by northeastern people. In Punjab, BJP President Amit Shah meets SED leaders, and government announces compensation to Punjabi settlers in Shillong. In Canada, US President Donald Trump blames Canada for destroying White House, and political shift is expected as Ontario goes to vote. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab.
Get the mortgage that's best for you from Abdul Kaiser, Principal Broker of Ingenious Mortgages. We offer first and second mortgages and refinancing. We deal with multiple lenders. We also conduct the REMIC course and exam to become a mortgage agent in just 1 week at our location. Call us at 416-887-9196 or log on to www.ingeniousmortgages.ca.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are... PM Narendra Modi will hold a bilateral meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping on the sidelines of the SCO summit in Qingdao on June 9. The meeting comes over a month after the two leaders held an informal summit in the Chinese city of Wuhan in April. The centre has set up a three-member committee for monitoring and redressal of grievances related to the alleged racial discrimination faced by the northeastern people. Any person or community hailing from the northeast who claims to be the victims of the alleged discrimination can file a complaint on the government's website. The centre has asked social media giant Facebook to respond to media reports about sharing of users' data without their explicit consent by June 20. The Government of India has expressed deep concerns about reports of such lapses and violations in Facebook's policies. Indian Railways have dropped its decision to enforce a three-decade-old rule to penalise passengers up to six times the stipulated amount for carrying excess baggage. Railways have now claimed that the move was made to generate awareness amongst the travellers. The centre has accorded top priority to secure release of six Indians abducted by the gunmen in Afghanistan last month. The government is in touch with all the stakeholders involved in the matter. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj is likely to meet the family members of the abducted Indians. Former President Pranab Mukherjee has addressed RSS workers at the valedictory function in Nagpur. The former president has warned that any attempt to define India through religion, dogma or intolerance will only dilute the country's existence. Many Congress leaders had expressed sharp disapproval of him participating in the event. A group of young Indian entrepreneurs have won a $1 million prize for developing a wearable smart device which women can use to send out emergency alerts if threatened. The New Delhi-based startup was inspired to find solutions for women's safety following the 2012 Nirbhaya gang rape case. The central government has decided to coordinate with various agencies and support efforts for an international alliance to ensure full protection to women and children from cyber crimes. Women and Child Development Minister Manika Gandhi has decided to complete the task within 3 months amid rising complaints of cyber crime. The much-awaited Rajnikanth starrer Kala released across 2,500 screens in India. The movie was not screened in Karnataka amid reports of vandalism by pro-Kannada groups in the state. The movie is facing protest in Karnataka over Rajnikanth's alleged comments on the Kaveri water issue. India woman cricketer Mithali Raj has become the first Indian to score 2,000 runs in T20I cricket, edging past Virat Kohli. Mithali has scored 2,015 runs in 74 T20Is with the help of 14 half-centuries. Mithali recently broke the record for the most ODI appearances by a woman cricketer with 194 ODIs to her name. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call. When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are... BJP President Amit Shah has met SED leaders in Chandigarh to discuss strategy for upcoming Lok Sabha elections in 2019. SED President Sukhbir Singh Badal has claimed that his party is permanent ally of BJP. Badal also urged other alliance partners to stand together ahead of the Lok Sabha polls. CM Captain Amrinder Singh has announced that his government would provide compensation to the Punjabi settlers whose shops were gutted during the recent violence in Shillong. The state government would also assist the settlers in completing an under-construction community-run school. Pathankot District and Sessions Court has framed charges against 7 of the 8 accused in the Kathua rape and murder case. The 8 accused in the case is a juvenile. An 8-year-old girl in Jammu and Kashmir's Kathua district was raped and murdered, erupting a massive outcry across the city. Haryana Special Task Force has nabbed notorious contract killer Sampath Nehra from Hyderabad. Nehra belongs to the gang of a well-known gangster Lawrence Bishnoi. Nehra was active in student politics at Punjab University. He is currently a resident of the police lines in Chandigarh. Panchkula court has dismissed bail application of Dera Chief's adopted daughter Honeypreet Insan. She had sought bail on the grounds that no evidence was found against her by the police. Haryana government had formed an SIT to investigate the Panchkula violence which had slapped sedition charges against Honeypreet. Permanent Lok Adalat in Kapurthala has slapped a fine of Rs 10,000 each on Health Minister Ram Mohendra and several others for alleged negligence towards duty. Mohendra and other health officials were summoned in a case alleging harassment of patients and doctors due to the lack of infrastructure at civil hospital. AAP has formed a 3-member committee to probe an alleged audio clip of conversation between 2 AAP leaders who are reportedly discussing how Sukhpal Khera and his group can be weakened. Several reports had recently claimed that the duo was discussing to finish off the opposition. A sacked employee along with an accomplice opened fire and injured Mitsubishi's human resource wing head in Gurugram. The incident occurred at around 9 a.m. when the victim Vinay Sharma was going to his office at Manesar in a car. He suffered 2 gunshot injuries. Sleuths of the anti-narcotic cell of Punjab police have arrested 2 drug peddlers and seized 3.5 kg opium from them. The peddlers are identified as Baldev Singh and Gurdeshwar Singh. Cops have arrested the duo following tip-off from an informer. World Bank has offered to sponsor the state projects for finding long-term solutions to problems related to water, agriculture and power. The announcement came soon after the World Bank County Director Junaid Ahmed met CM Captain Amrinder Singh. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDay.com as the news from Canada follows. Scans
Accounting. A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: US President Donald Trump had erroneously blamed Canada for the burning of the White House in the War of 1812 during a recent telephonic conversation with PM Justin Trudeau. Trudeau had reportedly pressed Trump on how he could justify the tariffs as a national security issue. Ontario could see a seismic political shift if Doug Ford's Tories beat out the NDP, their closest rival, and win a majority government, as the latest polls predicts. Either way, the vote will bring an end to the 15 years of Liberal government, as Premier Kathleen Wynne herself admitted. PM Justin Trudeau is meeting French President Emmanuel Macron on Parliament Hill to discuss how to handle US President Donald Trump at the G7 Leaders Summit. Macron and Trudeau are presenting a united front ahead of the G7 to tackle American tariffs. Canadian government will hold a key auction of wireless spectrum of fifth generation mobile networks in 2020. Innovation Minister Navdeep Bains noted Canada will be ahead of Australia and Germany and will be among the top 5 countries to make spectrum available for 5G. A new study conducted has found little evidence that legalized marijuana poses a threat to public health and safety. Researchers found benefits such as drop in alcohol sales and fatal opioid overdoses. The Bill C-45 to legalize marijuana is set to go for a final vote in the upper house. Canada's housing market and high levels of consumer indebtedness has remained the top vulnerabilities for the financial system. According to the Bank of Canada's latest financial system review, both concerns have shown the signs of easing. Ontario's police watchdog is investigating a shootout in East Toronto that left a civilian dead and an officer hospitalized. Police were called to Commercial Plaza shortly after midnight with reports of a man with a weapon. Police exchanged fire with the man, hitting him several times while an officer was hit once. A long-awaited legislation to ratify Canada's participation in the Comprehensive and Progressive Trans-Pacific Partnership Free Trade Deal will be presented in Parliament. The deal will open a market of 500 million consumers and 40% of the world economy to the Canadian exports. Marked activists posing as G7 leaders mimicked household tasks in front of the Quebec City's legislature as what the first of the series of the demonstrations and protests kicked off. The event, staged by aid organization Oxfam, is protesting to highlight women's unpaid labor and to improve social services such as childcare. A second Chinese tourist among 24 people injured in a bus crash in eastern Ontario has died of injuries sustained during the crash. A tour bus carrying 37 people, including 35 Chinese tourists, crashed into a rock formation by the side of a highway in Ontario. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best inter-Canadian businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Welcome to the Field Fresh Supermarket. One-stop shop for fresh vegetables, fruits, bakery products, Indian and Chinese grocery and much more. Visit us today at 5661 Steeles Avenue East in Scarborough. Major intersection Steeles and Middlefield. Check out our weekly flyers. Field Fresh Supermarket, always fresh.
Actor Kartik Aaryan, who is riding high after the success of his last film, Sonu Kitty to his Sweetie, says there is nothing wrong between him and his mentor and director, Love Ranjan. Kartik was interacting with the media at the GQ 100 Best Dressed Awards 2018 here in Mumbai on Saturday. On the buzz around a fallout between the two due to monetary issues, Kartik said,
"Mera aur Love sir ka aaj tak discussion nahi hua hai paison ko lekar. So I don't know ye kahan se kya aa raha hai. And matlab hum dono ne career saath mein shuru kiya hai. To paison ka kabhi bhi discussion hua nahi aur aage bhi future project bhi jo hum log karenge usme kabhi nahi hoga." Which one? मैं कुछ कमेंट नहीं करना चाहूँगा अभी किसी बारे में, बट ये सब स्पेक्यूलेशंस हैं, सारी बातें पता नहीं कहाँ से आ रही हैं. But there is nothing wrong between me and Love sir, and I think हम जैसे पहले थे वैसे अभी भी हैं.
Kartik was happy to attend the event as being on the GQ Best Dressed list had been his childhood dream. He came despite a ligament injury.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
Superstar Shah Rukh Khan, who is a father of three, Aryan, Suhana and Abram, says children should hear their own music and believe in their own dreams. Abram turned 5 on Sunday and Shah Rukh tweeted a photograph of his youngest son, whom he calls his sunshine. "My sunshine turns 5 years today, but he thinks he's 9. Please do not tell him otherwise if you meet him. Children should hear their own music, sing their own songs and believe in their own little dreams. And yeah, hug their papa a lot," Shah Rukh wrote alongside the image. Mom Gauri Khan also shared some pictures and just wrote, "Happy birthday, my gorgeous." Shah Rukh married Gauri in October 1991. They have a son, Aryan, and daughter, Suhana. In 2013, they became parents of their third child, Abram, who was born through surrogacy. On the acting front, Shah Rukh will next be seen in Anand L. Rai's upcoming film Zero, along with Anushka Sharma and Katrina Kaif.
Karol Bagh Jewelers, gehniyan de latest design layi pehli choice. Sone ate hire de set, chudiyan ate kade, chain, ਜੜਾਉ ਸੈੱਟ ਅਤੇ ਹੋਰ ਵੀ ਕਈ ਗਹਿਣਿਆਂ ਤੇ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਡਿਸਕਾਊਂਟ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵੱਡੀ ਚੁਆਇਸ ਬਿਹਤਰੀਨ ਸਰਵਿਸ ਅਤੇ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵਾਜਿਬ ਰੇਟਾਂ ਲਈ ਆਓ ਕਰੋਲ ਬਾਗ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ ਅਤੇ ਰੂਪ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ ਕਰੋਲ ਬਾਗ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ 1098 ਪੀਟਰ ਰੋਬਰਟਸਨ ਬੁਲੇਵਾਰਡ ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ ਰੂਪ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ 503 Ray Lawson Boulevard, Brampton.